news. Hold on, world, that's got the blues. Seem like being out the door. Hey, good day. This is Robert Jeter. You on the Blues in the News, Robert Jeter Show. Coming to you directly from Atlanta, Georgia. Just a little of my two cents on what's going on in the world. Try to play a little music, a little news. Try to keep you entertained. It's off the cuff, unedited. And, you know, I just shoot the breeze, basically. But it's good for me. It's good for my mental health. I hope anybody listening to this has helped their mental health a little bit as well. Because, you know, we got a lot going on in the world, as you well know. So, I mean, I'm going to do these little podcasts every now and then, directly from my phone, actually. So I am mobile. Reminds me of a Who tune, you know, the rock group Who. I'm only mobile. I got songs in my head all the time, you see. Anyway, I'm crazy about that. But so I thought I'd come out every now and then talk about the absurdity of the day. Because every morning you wake up, right? Hopefully you wake up. There's something absurd that's happened during that day. You know, it just, where am I? I mean, it didn't used to be this absurd, right? Of course, the war is absurd. Any war is absurd. And the war right now between Israel and Hamas, it started back up, huh? Just started back up because they tried to cease fire. They got some hostages out. But, you know, they broke the ceasefire. Hamas broke the ceasefire. And I don't think the rest of the hostages have much time. I mean, one of the absurd things I saw that recently on the news is these hostages being released by their captors. You know, the guys, the bad guys, right? I mean, Hamas guys, you know, the terrorists. They all got these little green bands around their heads, and they all hide their faces with the hood. So nobody knows who they are, but we know they are. We know they're the bad guys, right? So, and the thing is, you see these captors, you know, waving to their captors, you know, saying, "Hey, I'm so glad you're releasing me, but we really had a good time." And they're smiling, and, you know, everything is hunky-dory. It's like they're the best of buddies, you know. It's like they've been partying, you know, in luxury all this time. When, in fact, these women have probably been raped many times and been abused many times. And who knows what's happened to these people. But yet they're forced to be happy as they leave, because it's all about PR, right? And we know Hamas and the Arabs, generally speaking, are very good at psychology, at pushing their PR, and they do a very, very good job of it. Look what's happening on our campuses everywhere, right? So this whole thing is absurd. I mean, now many things are absurd, right? But this is the absurdity of the day. That's all I'm saying. These are absurd. The absurdity of the day of these people being forced to look like they're happy when we know they're miserable and they'll probably suffer from their experience the rest of their lives because of this. But anyway, in the meantime, keep your head up, be safe, be cool, you know, don't get too excited, and, you know, justice will prevail one way or another, and the good always wins out in the end. So I'll leave you with that and some more music. Maybe I'll play some more music on the way out because this is just a few minutes here. You know, I'm not being on here long. It's Friday. It's TGIF day, and everybody wants to have a good time for the weekend. Hopefully you have a good, safe weekend. See you next time. Robert Jeter, Blues and the News.
Then I was king of a highway. Trying to make it look fast and easy, and dreaming of.